Avery Wayman,
Reese Compton,
and Ella Thomas. And this is about water on Earth.
Did you know 75% of Earth is water?
Also, did you know 97.5% of water is salt water and 2.5% is salt fresh water?
The water cycle describes how water evaporates from the surface of the earth, rises snow and clouds, and falls again to the surface as precipitation.
The sun is what makes the water cycle work. The sun provides what almost everything on Earth needs to go. Heat causes liquid and frozen water to evaporate.
Go.
75% of Earth's water is water, and 1% of water is drinkable. 3% of water is fresh water. 97% of Earth's water is salt water. The water cycle describes how water evaporates from the atmosphere, cools and condenses into rain or snow and clouds, and falls again to the surface as precipitation. The sun causes the water cycle to occur.
Yes, that's how we do it.
Hi, my name is Bailey.
Hi, my name is Manson.
Hi, my name is Gavin.
Hi, my name is Brady.
Okay, we want to talk to you about a very important subject today, and that will be water cycles.
Water plays many different roles on the Earth. Some is at the poles and in ice caps, and some is in the snow and glaciers at the top of high mountains. Some is in lakes and streams, and some is in underground. Some is vapor in the atmosphere, but most of the water on Earth is in the oceans.
Water is always on the move. The sun's energy causes water to evaporate from the oceans and lake into the atmosphere. Plants and animals can release water vapor into the atmosphere as they breathe. When the atmosphere cools, water vapor condenses, makes clouds, and might produce rain or snow. Water has been recycled in its different forms as ice, liquid, or vapor for more than 3.5 billion years.
Okay, now we are going to show you a quick little pictures. Now please pay attention to the screen.
Here are diagrams of the water cycle. We're just going to take a quick minute to show you these.
Okay, now we'll go back.
Okay, now we're going to show you a quick video, and it will be on the water cycle. Okay.
Did you just start it? I was going the whole time.
The same water flowing in a continuous loop, falling as rain and snow from clouds to the Earth's surface, running in rivers, just mean in ponds, flowing from faucets, irrigating crops.
Quiet!
It's because Earth has this perfect water cycle. The water cycle. So simple, even small children understand the basics. Yet so complex, the most advanced Earth scientists, hydrologists, geologists, and biogeochemists are studying every part and process. The water cycle is fascinating. It's something that's around us all the time, and yet we don't really understand it. How to summarize what is known about the water cycle? With two words, flows and stores. The water cycle is a series of flows of water between various water stores or storages. Clouds in the atmosphere.
There's always a little bit of water in the atmosphere. We talk about relative humidity. It's a humid day, it's a dry day. Either way, there's water, sometimes a little, sometimes a lot.
There's a lot of water in the ocean, 70% of all the water on Earth. In the ice sheets and glaciers, two-thirds of all the fresh water on Earth. In the snowpacks atop mountains like the Sierra Nevada. In the Great Lakes, in rivers and streams, in reservoirs and watersheds, in wetlands, in the soil, in and on plants and trees rooted in the soil, and beneath the soil, in water tables and underground aquifers like the Ogallala High Plains, which runs underneath parts of eight states from South Dakota to Texas. All this storage is temporary. Water in all is always in flux.
Okay, we hope you learned something today, and we hope you can learn something from the lesson today. Thank you.